I don't know, man. I was talking to my wife about that this week. She said, baby, when are you going to stop?
Don't stop.
Well, I can't stop because what I'm going to do? What I'm going to do? I'm not the guy that wants to do nothing. Plus, I mean, I got a good job. You know, you think about all the jobs I got. I wake up. I play music. I tell jokes. I wake up, I meet y'all, I tell some more jokes. I get paid to play music, adult contemporary music. I play R&B. I tell jokes. And they give me a check. Hey, man, can I tell you something? That's the most amazing gift. If you could change the way you wake up in the morning, stop saying, I got to go to work. I got to work out. I got to get this weight off of me. I got to go and meet with the people at the school. I got to deal with my coworkers. Change one word in that sentence, and everything about your life changes. I get to wake up in the morning. I get to go to work. I get to go and meet with these people today. When you say I got to, you take all of your opportunities and all of your blessings and you wrap them up in stress by saying I got to. You take all the stress off of it when you say I get to.
Living by instinct elevates your ability to know where you are going and how to get there. It can help you know when to slow down and step back and when to accelerate and step up. And it can ultimately guide you to what you're ultimately looking for. All of those people that you've been looking to guide you into what you need, they don't have the key.
Yes, sir.
The key is in you.
Yes, sir.
It's in your instincts. The answer you seek from them is in you. And while you're hanging around, God is causing what he worked into you to be worked out of you. And all of that crying and kicking and screaming you do because he's not allowing you to retreat back into your little safe place and shut yourself.
I think it was Viktor Frankl who said, don't ask what the meaning of life is. He said, ask what is the meaning of your life. Don't ask what the meaning of life is. Ask what is the meaning of your life. And just looking back at my life and my hunger to share with you some of the things and decisions that I've made so that you don't make those same mistakes. So you can say, wait, let's talk about this. I don't need to do that because he already made that mistake. He already paid that price. So if you feel that I could have some value to share with you things I've experienced and you're open to listen, because I'm not locked into sharing with you things that you don't want. I believe in the saying, don't speak where you are not heard. That's why my favorite book says, don't cast pearls before swines, lest they turn and rend you. That people get upset, angry, okay? So my goal is not to make you angry. I do want to make you feel good. I do want to inspire you. I do want to make you laugh, okay? So I want you to think about what I'm going to share with you now. Don't knock on an open door. I wish someone had said that to me years ago. Years ago. Because for a long period of time, I was seeking answers, trying to find success. going through all type of self-discovery processes, putting a lot of time and energy searching to discover myself, looking for ways in which I could be able to provide for my family, be able to take care of my mother, be able to do something that was me.
Only way that you can be impactful is you must be successful in something. And when you find yourself successful at something, then you realize it's not just one thing I must be successful in, but it's many things that I must be successful in. Why? Because you're always being watched. Impact only begins the day that you figure out, wow, people are actually paying attention to me. But even when they're not, let me tell you what impact really, really becomes impactful when you're by yourself. When nobody knows what you're thinking. When nobody knows your habits, when nobody knows what you're reading, when nobody knows what you're listening to, become successful and watch how you piss your haters off. Become successful and watch how you tell the devil, I'm not playing your tricks. So if you want to be an impactful person in this world, then figure out the things that you're good at to make sure you're successful at those things. And when you become successful, if you want to go back to the word impact, don't stop impacting people. Learn how to impact them differently. And one of the things I always preach and teach is always meet them exactly where they are. Because if you really want to impact someone's life, you don't want them to be like you. You want them to grab something from you so they can be a better them. Because success, I told you, can be an isolated thing. Right? Sometimes you can bring success alone and you can bring people along the ride and they can have success with you. But man, when you impact them, you change their life forever. Forever. That's what a legacy is, right? A legacy is leaving an impact that when you're gone, your name lives forever.
Taking responsibility for whatever happens to you. Knowing that you have consciously made the decisions that are now affecting you. Knowing that what is happening now, today, is the direct result of your activity, what you did yesterday. Self-reliance is basically counting on yourself. Now, being self-reliant doesn't mean you can't work with others or trust others. Self-reliance means counting on yourself, trusting yourself, being confident with yourself, being responsible to yourself, trusting your own instincts. Trusting the conclusions that you have developed from your study of experiences and philosophies. Taking the credit that is due you. Learning from the mistakes that you have made. Being self-reliant. Gestalt psychologists give an example of being self-reliant. They say that you're responsible for getting caught in the rain. They say that by deciding not to carry an umbrella every day, you have made the decision to endure an occasional drenching. Translation? By not being prepared, you make the choice of getting caught in some of life's unpleasant circumstances. Be they rain, failures, economic losses, relationship losses, professional losses, personal losses. By not being prepared, thinking ahead, it's your choice. Now here's the other side of it. By being prepared, you increase your chances of success. You increase the likelihood. By being prepared, you increase your chances of success, of seizing opportunities when they come your way, of being ready within yourself to take advantage of once-in-a-lifetime situations. Some people tend to blame others for their mistakes, blame others for their failures. Somebody says, it's not my fault the report isn't done. So-and-so didn't do their part. Of course it's your fault. It's your report too. It's your responsibility to see that everyone you delegated work to does their part. Now you can't control what others around you do, but it's in your own best self-interest, your enlightened self-interest, that you stay on top of things, especially if it's going to affect your future. You think your boss cares that John didn't do his part? You think he sees John as the bad guy? Of course not. All he sees is that the report isn't done. Bottom line. Be responsible for the things that affect you. You can make sure you're more responsible by checking in with those people who are working with you, the people who make up your team. You can be more responsible by saying, "Hey, John, how are you doing with your part? Do you need some help? Can we put somebody else in here to help you finish?" Now, if John consistently doesn't handle his part, you've got to replace John. If he isn't doing his share, you've got to find somebody that will. Or what? It will negatively affect you. You can't wake up in the morning that the project is due hoping and wishing that John has done his part. No, you've got to be responsible because it's going to affect your career too. Now, my approach to my better future very early on in my career was to just go through the day with my fingers crossed. And I used to say something like, "I sure hope things will change for the better." Then here's what I found out. They're not going to change. Somebody says, "Well then, how will my life ever change?" Answer, when you change. When you change.